Looking for a free AI tool that can make your avatar talk, walk, dance,
or even speak different languages just like me? Then stop searching.
Because my humble self too is AI avatar, you can borrow me.
Even me, oh, you feel still borrow me. Please, my daughter, show them how made us.
Okay, thank you so much, Grandma. So today I'll take you through on how you can generate your avatars using free AI tool, completely free. You can look at the avatars that you watch from beginning. You can see the excellent motions that every one of them carries. These days, avatars are no longer head tokens. Now they can do whatever that you want them to do. So on this tutorial, what you will do not skip any part, because everything I'm going to show you today is very important, as long as this tutorial is concerned. So before that, what we would do today, I'll show you from beginning how I was able to generate the images and how I generated the videos as well using these free AI tools. But before we dive in, let's hear this.
Welcome to my channel. This is AI Mastery Tutorial, your one-stop, step-by-step AI tutorials. Please subscribe to join us.
Okay, we will use two free AI tools to work on this project today. The first one is to generate our image, and we are using Google Studio to generate our image. Why I'm using Google Studio is so that you will not have any watermark attached to your image. Now the second one we're using to generate our videos will be Grok AI. So I'll put you through step by step on how we run this thing from beginning to the end. Let's start now. So step one.
So on our step one, you open your Chrome and type aistudio.google.com. So the link, I've dropped the link of this website on the description box. You can as well download it using your Play Store, as in the app, okay? But for now, we are using the Chrome to do it. So when it opens, it will come up this way, and it will ask you to sign in using your Gmail account. So you simply sign in, log in your account using your Gmail account, and when you open it, to open this way. Let me zoom it so that we can see everything clearly the way it is. You can see it written here, Google AI Studio. So here you have chat, stream, generative images, build, history. So we are going straight to point. What we are using now is to generate media. So we'll click on generate media. When you click generate media, it will come over this way. See, have create generative media. On it we have try nano banana, we have Gemini speech generation, we have imaging, we have Lyria real time, and we have Veo. You can agree with me that Veo 3 that is running everywhere is a product of Google AI, and as well the Nano Banana is a product of Google. Even the Gemini itself, which we use for photo editing, is also a Google product. So we are using imaging on this studio. We are using imaging. You touch the imaging here. When you touch imaging, it will open for you this way. It says generate images with imaging. Okay, now when you scroll to this left side, you can see how it is. You see how it is here. You can scroll to this place. Let's look at here what is this place showing us. You can see here. So over here now in the imaging, we have imaging 4. That's the model we are using, and they have number of results. That's how many images do you want them to display at a go. Do you want them to be 1 or up to 4? For me, I prefer using 2, because even if you use 4, almost all of them always look alike. Then you have aspect ratio. You have 1:1, 9:16, 16:9, 4, and all of them. So whichever ratio that is suitable for you, you simply choose the ratio. For me, we are using ratio 16:9, which is a landscape for YouTube videos, okay? Now the output resolution, you can leave it in 1000 or 2000, but let's leave it in 1000 for space sake, all right? So we'll move ahead. Now after that one, the next thing here, this is where you have to scroll down to the bottom for you to see where to type in your description. So this is where they will say describe your image is you scroll down to the bottom of the page for you to see it. Now over here, let's create that image of that grandma. Okay, let's use grandma as our illustration. Now look at what I type here. I say a Nigerian grandma of 70 sitting on a bed in luxury bedroom carrying her grandson. So by looking at this image, now you agree with me that it's going to be a flashy and classy image that they will give to us. Okay, so when you are done with your prompt, you just hit run. When you press the run button, it will load and come this way. You can see our image is out. Let's zoom out and see what they gave to us. You can see our image is out. This is a grandma with her grandson. Let's look at the other one too. A grandma with her grandson. So which one should we use? We can just make use of any of them. The images are so lovely. And I'm confused on the one to select here now. So okay, let's use this one. Let's just use this one. Just for tutorial sake, let's use this one. So I choose this one and I hit this download. When you hit the download, it will take you to your download session. Just you can type in a name for it or you just hit save. Okay, remember this is the download sign. Okay, so when we are done with this, this will now take us to step two. Step two will be where we will generate the image, where we will generate the video, make the avatar to talk, make it to say whatever that we want to do. So we'll be going ahead to use our Grok AI to do the magic. Now let's move over to Grok. I already have Grok on my desktop here. Look at it here. You can as well go to your Google Play. You can go to your Google Play Store and download your Grok from there. Okay, so when you download Grok, it will ask you to log in. Kindly log in using your Gmail account as well. So when you open it will come up this way. Now we are going to make use of the imaging. You can see where they write it free. It's free. So we'll touch the imaging here. When you touch the imaging, it will first of all show you the last things that you did. You can see that our grandma's image is already there. Okay, so let's first of all generate this bus here. There is one thing with this group, we have to pay attention. Pay clear attention. We are starting the major work now. So on this place now, let's say I want to eliminate this avatar, this man here. You can see once you touch it, automatically they will generate video by themselves. That's how Grok work. If you look over here, down here, you can see percentage is counting already, meaning that they are generating video already without you giving them command. Initially, let's check here. Even when the video is generating, let's talk about this arrow. You can see this arrow on my previous videos on Grok. You will notice where they have speech, they have fun, they have fancy, but now it's no longer like that. So our video is already down.
Thank you for joining me today. I'm looking forward to our discussion.
Okay.
Thank you for joining me today.
Let's pause it.
I'm looking forward to our discussion. Thank you for joining me today. I'm looking forward to our discussion.
So you can see this is they have already generated the video for you. And the video, you can't even pause it, you can't do anything. So now it left for you now to give your own prompt, the way you want your image to react, the way you want your avatar, whatever you want your avatar to say, is what we are going to do now. But whatever what they generated here, you can see, you'll agree with me that is perfect. It's just like your tree, but their own is even more perfect than your tree. Initially, they were doing trial by errors. If you check my previous Grok videos that I made initially, you notice that they were doing trial by error, but now they have upgraded. So let's move over and take my prompt.
Thank you for joining.
So this is my prompt. I've already arranged my prompt, what I want the avatars to say. Okay, this is for this my bros. I've named the bros Richard. Okay, so I copy my prompt here. Then we'll move over to Grok again. Okay, now over here now in Grok, you will touch this arrow here and touch on custom. With the custom, you'll be able to put in your dialogue, what and however you want your image to be. So now look at what I did. I said dialogue with motions. Very important. Pay attention to this. Always tell it to generate with motions. Else it will generate without much of it, okay? Now this is what I want the avatar to run. I named this our bros, Richard. I said, Richard is going to tell us, because my humble self to his AI avatar, he squeezed his face as camera zooms in. You can borrow me too. So this is what I want the avatar to say. You can see, notice what I did here. Notice what I did here. Notice my command. I say he squeezed. This he squeezed is an instruction that I give. And it have to be in brackets. You have to open a bracket and close a bracket whenever you are done with your instruction. And if you want a dialogue, don't forget to put it dialogue. Then name the image and put a semicolon. Now let's hit generate and see what will happen. So you can see it's generating again. You will allow it. It doesn't take much time at all. So our video is ready. Let's see. Do you notice the way he squeezed his face? Now let's look at this. The instruction I gave, he started the instruction from beginning, and that's not exactly what I want. Look at him squeezing his face from beginning instead of after saying the first sentence. So what we'll do here is to change the instruction we gave. Stick at what I did now. I changed the instruction. I say, Richard, I open an instruction. I say, smiling. Then he now say this. He then squeezed his face and then says this. Let's see how this one will generate. Is generating. Let's see the difference between the two. Now the video is ready and this one is perfect. Do you notice this? Look at this.
Because my humble self too is AI avatar, you can borrow me.
Do you notice the motion on this video?
Because my humble self too is AI avatar, you can borrow me.
So when we are done, you just download it from here. When you are done, you download. Look at this place. You download it here. It's showing downloading. Download started. Now let's look at this very well. You can see the previous one we generated, and you see the second one we generated. Now this one started with a smile, and then he now squeeze and continue. And the words were perfectly well. You cannot agree less than this. Or you can still let me know in the comment section if the generation is actually worth it or not. Okay? Now, let's go to the mama. Let's pick mama. Let's generate mama. So, for you to generate another one, you go back. We'll go back and pick grandma. Let's go back and pick grandma. I can see, remember, once you pick an image, they will start generating the image by themselves. So, let's allow them to finish generating it and see what they will give us. Alright, see what they generated for grandma. Okay, grandma is cuddling her grandson. Alright, now let's move over to our own. Let's tell grandma something to say. Remember, you touch the arrow, you touch custom. Then you put in your prompt. I've already have my prompt. See what I say? Dialogue with motions. Mama, that's the name of name grandma. Mama is happy. You can see a blanket. The action here is happy. She is happy while saying something. She said, even me, oh, you fit still borrow me. Please, my daughter, show them how you made us. That's what grandma is going to say. Let's send it. All right, grandma's video is ready. You can see. Let's hear her.
Even me, oh, you fit still borrow me. Please, my daughter, show them how made us.
All right, you can see how everything is working out. You can see how wonderful their generations is. I tell you, this app is for now is still free. It has been free since a month now, since ever they started. They've been trying several things, and I tell you, Grok has improved a lot. You will agree with me that their conversations are wonderful. Now Can these things dance? Remember, we are talking about Avatar. Let's make Mama to dance with her grandchild. So let's say Grandma dancing with her grandson. Joyfully. Now let's make her to dance. So say Grandma dancing with her grandson joyfully. Let's see this one again. Hey, look at Grandma dancing with her grandson. Okay, all right people, so let me know in the comment section if there is anything you did not understand on today's tutorial. Please let me know. Don't forget to put your actions, the action you how you want the avatar to do, put them in a bracket. I have dropped examples of the prompts, the way I generated this thing, right there in the description box. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to like it. See you on the next one. Bye for now.